you for joining us back on I2I at the Rapture Broadcasting Network. I2I, as you know, is a program where you're interviewing anointed men of God from all over the world with different skills, different talents. God has ordained different people in different ways to be used mightily for the kingdom of God. And today, we are going to meet with a man of God who had a wave of popularity during his prime times. And even now, I should say it's the most prime time of his. In fact, he was a playback singer. Who has been adored, applauded by the world for 22 long years in the South Indian industry and in the Indian industry particularly, and where he's been sung for several very famous actors in the South Indian industry. And 22 years he has been a great singer in the film industry. And then he decided that he will now sing for the living God alone. And he set apart his life for Christ. And he's an amazing personality who is now singing to the Lord, praising the Lord, and inspiring others to be led by Christ, inspiring others to be a witness, to inspire others to know what is that Christ, what is the great life that has really changed and transformed his life. He's none other than Brother Jollee Abraham, the well-known playback singer turned to be a great singer for the living God. And today is inspiring the hearts of many people, singing awesome Christian music from the lyrics of the Bible that is really touching the hearts of people, giving them a lot of peace, leading them to worship. And today he is setting apart a good example, going ahead even to the remotest parts of India and other places, telling about the great testimony, telling about what changed him, what really transformed him into the life that he's into right now. He's got this ministry called Music Care. And we will come to know more about him in a few minutes. And I'm sure you're going to be inspired. I'm sure you're going to enjoy the session. So stay tuned on to I2I as we meet Brother Jollee Abraham. Brother Jollee Abraham, welcome to I2I at the Rapture Broadcasting Network.
It's a pleasure to be here with RBN.
Thank you very much.
Yeah.
I'm sure the audience wants to know all about Brother Jollee. I don't know whether you have been interviewed ever.
It's the first time I'm being with you.
I'm so glad that we are interviewing you for the first time at the RBN.
Yeah.
And naturally, we know many people can sing, but not all of them are gifted singers. And you are a gifted singer, and whether you say it or not, the world knows.
Glory to God.
Glory, all praises to Him. And when did you ever know that you have this talent for singing?
When I was studying at the 8th standard in Sacred Arts College, Thevara, I was studying in Sacred Arts School. At that time, there was a period for 1 hour. Okay. It is for extracurricular activities.
All right.
So some people will do one act, and some people will give speech, and that for me, as far as I know only music.
Okay.
So I used to sing. Uh-huh. So my classmates, they were waiting for that Friday to listen some songs,
listen to your
music. And new songs I used to sing. So they were very happy, and I became popular because of that.
Mm-hmm.
So my class teacher was watching all these things. So he found that he's eligible for our anniversary function, he can sing. That he decided, I didn't know.
All right.
So one day he came and said in front of all the, in front of students, okay. He said, Jollee, you are going to sing this year, anniversary function.
Okay.
When he said that, I was very proud, you know, that I, you know, was getting color of like, I felt very happy.
Okay.
So I told.
You felt really honored.
Really honored. And the day was nearing to, you know, the anniversary function, I was scared. I didn't have the guts to go to the stage.
Nervousness
started. I couldn't go to the stage. Yeah. I was thinking. Then I decided somehow I had to escape.
Okay.
So how to escape? That was my idea.
Okay.
So I found only singing, only through one thing only I can escape. So what I did is I told, one day, I still remember, you know, the day I wanted to meet the principal, 5 days early,
okay.
Before the function, you know, okay. 2 days or 3 days early, I went to him without taking bath, mudi, hair ella ipdi vechi oru scene ella create for him.
Okay.
I did made a scene and I went to him.
Okay.
I with the innocent, you know, feeling, innocent heart, I told him, sir, I'm having fever.
Okay.
The next dialogue that I said, I don't think I'll be able to sing. That would have been the last thing. Instead of that, I said, sir, I'm not feeling well. I have severe fever and everything. My eyes are red. I made it red, and then only I went. Then he said, and immediately second dialogue was, I don't think I'll be able to sing. So he looked at me and he said, oh, you are not feeling well. That's so, what have you, any medicine? I said, I'm having medicine, something like that. He said, you'll be all right. On Sunday, you'll be all right.
Okay.
Immediately I said, no, sir, I won't be all right. I said.
I won't be all right.
Yeah. He said, then at last he said, whether you are all right or not, you are singing.
Okay.
That's all. That's the ultimate thing. And he left the place. Then no way. Then I have to go to the stage. Then I have to prepare for the stage. Somehow I prepared, I was shivering, I went to the stage. Then with the orchestra, all the people are there, no? And I was shivering like anything, but still I went to the stage and I sang S. Janaki song.
What song was that?
Talirita kinakardhan thamara malavangan vilichit ും വരുന്നില്ലൻ വിരുന്നുകാരൻ എൻ്റെ വിരുന്നുകാരൻ.
That
song. When I started singing, then silence, and after the song, big clap. That was the first.
The first applause
I got it. Then I found that I can't sing, you know. Like my inner mind was telling, okay, you'll be able to sing.
Okay.
That was the start. Okay. Then afterwards, in the college also.
How old were you then when this was?
Eight, 13 years old. So then I was called to college. We have a college opposite side. College functional, they started calling me, singing like that. And then it went on like that. Then because of my singer, I got admission. At that time, getting admission is not so easy. I got the admission, whatever I want. I wanted for second group. I got admission. Then college, I started singing.
Okay.
And all the competition, I used to get first prize.
All right.
Became very popular, getting popularity in that way. It went on like that.
When did you get into the movies?
Movies like this incident I still remember. After the pre-degree, I was singing. Then I joined to the BSc Botany in.
Okay.
I was during that period. I was very popular in singing on the stage. I used to symbol all temples and all
in
the.
In that region, you were popular.
In India. Not in India. In Kerala.
In Kerala, basically.
Rotary Club program, Lions Club program, and then all the temples program, and like I was busy and I was making money also.
Okay.
So I was very happy it was going on. So during that period, then I finished my graduation.
Mm-hmm.
That time also I was singing. Then one day I still remember I went for a program, and the program was grand success. People were clapping. That is the reward, you know, like they were clapping, and I was very happy.
They were appreciated.
And I was there was a dinner for me with all my artists, and it's a big table. I remember some rich person's house, you know. And then I was about to eat. That time, one person, an old gentleman, came to me, and I said, "What are you, Mr. Abraham?" I said, "I finished my graduation." He said, "Oh, you didn't get any other job?" After sincerity, he said, "You know, you didn't get any." At that time, you know, after graduation, nobody goes for singing like that. They'll go for working in some company or
the
like
bank,
bank or something. You didn't get any job? Or, you know, that was a hit for me, because, you know, where, you know, as if I have selected this because I didn't get any job, and all of that
your,
feeling.
Your pride fell. You know?
Yeah, yeah.
The pride
and
that the singing was a big carry.
Yeah, but that's gone on that day. Then I was thinking, hey, why this guy is, I'm making a lot of money, and then why you guys talking like that? I was a little upset. I couldn't eat properly. I went home.
Okay.
And I still remember I reached home by early morning, 2 o'clock.
Okay.
At that time, my mother, I asked her, I want to eat something. She asked me, "You didn't eat anything?" I said, "Yes, I didn't." Because then I said, one nasty person, one person asked me this like this. And I was not happy. I said like this. Then she kept quiet. That made me more. Then my anger was towards my...
Was he right? Was what you
then mother also is not supporting me like that. I felt. Then next day morning, I had to go for another concert. So I was having a breakfast with, then mother came, she gave me the food, and I was sitting, she was sitting next to me. Again, this was in my heart, no? So I brought, why that guy said like that? He could have kept quiet, no? Whereas I'm making more money, and why, than a bank manager, than a person, I was making this much money, then why should he ask like that? Then also she kept quiet. And repeatedly, I want a support from her. I was doing that.
So you thought there's an element of truth in it?
Yeah, know? Yeah, something like that. After 3 times when I said, she said, "What is wrong in him?" He said like that. Nothing wrong. He said the correct thing. He said, you have no base in the film industry. You are singing somebody's songs and getting some money. That's all. So you don't have a base in the film industry. You are nothing in the film industry. You are singing some other songs, Rafi songs or Yeshuda songs or brother songs, something like that, singing and getting some money, that's all. What is wrong in his statement?
Yeah.
It was a great blow to me. Then that day onwards, my intention should go to Madras or Bombay or somewhere and do something and sing for the film. That's all. I can't go straight away from during that, but I was in Kalabhavan, no? Kalabhavan, Father Abil, you heard about him. And Dasyatan was also there. So Dasyatan and then HMB, his master's voice, Chennai, they wanted a recording of 4 songs. Out of 4 songs, 2 songs by Dasyatan, 2 songs by me. That itself is a good first offer.
So, because you're singing with Yeshudas Di.
That
time the most popular
singer. Yeah, yeah. So, then I went, he came, he was settled in Chennai. I went from here, I went and sang 2 songs. That song was on Thalathil Vellam Eduthu Venkachayumarayil Chutti Mishihadan Shishyan Marudi Padangal Karugi.
Spiritual song.
Padangal Karugi. And that was spiritual
song in the film.
Yeah. No, no, not in the film. It was for album, no?
Okay.
Like at that time, HMB was releasing a Christian album.
Okay.
So, and another song was Kartave Kaniyaname. That was by M.K. Arjuna. We did the music director. So, it was a successful thing.
Okay.
Because I was a graduate, so I have the inner that feeling that I can speak to everybody. That confidence I got it. That was the thing because I studied after the graduation. That confidence made me something, you know, I can talk to anybody, I can be anywhere. That made me, after going and after finishing all the recording, when I was leaving from there, I thought, why can't I say bye-bye to my manager? His name was Alfred Tangaya. I should go. I just went inside. Hi, sir, how are you? Like that, I started speaking. He was watching, like, my attitude, everything. He was, suddenly, what's your plan? I said, my plan is come to Madras or Bombay. Why not Bangalore? I said, no, I'm not interested. Then why is like that? I said, I want to sing in the film. Then immediately he said, are you interested to join here in HMB? HMB means recording company. So I said, I'll be the happiest person to join here. And he said, then you try your luck. There'll be an interview. Maybe up to 20 days, we'll publish in the paper. And I was waiting for that. Then I saw the ad, I applied, I went for the interview, I got through.
Okay.
I went to Chennai as a recording officer, his master's voice, okay. Gramophone Company of India.
Okay.
I was working there. Then, you know, here you can imagine, every week I was performing, I was getting money and that all gone, and now I am in Chennai. I was in Madras at that time. Madras is for a salary. Salary, like people like me, this much money I was earning, and here that money will be finishing within within 10 days, 15 days.
Yeah.
When I want to live in a house, separate house.
Capacity has come down.
Yeah, separate house and with a cook I was staying. So I need money. So I started singing concert.
Okay.
Every Saturday, Sunday, I was singing concert. One day I was performing in museum theater. At that time, so many people, you know, when I'm singing, after singing, a lot of girls, boys, everybody, youngsters, they come and say, you sang very well, autograph, everything here. At that time, see, automatically at that age, we always give preference to the girls, you know, when they come, okay, we don't bother about all these people.
True.
It is going on.
Yeah.
So I was finishing everything, I saw one couple, you know, husband and wife, they were standing. They said, in between, hi, Jollee. But then I went to them. I said, are you interested to sing for the film? Then I said, I'll be the happiest person. I thought so many people said like that. He is also one among them. That was my mentality. But I spoke to him. And he said, gave me the card. When I looked at the card, Sri Kumar and Thambi. I was very much happy to see him, surprised to see him actually. So he told me to come next Monday to his house, after 2 days. So I said, I was waiting for that day. You know, I went to the church and prayed to give me the courage to face all this. First time, you know, I'm going. So prayed, and after the prayer, automatically, I still remember, we got whoever it may be, I can face the, you know, that courage I got. I went, and when I reached the home, he came and, come and sit here. Then he said, talk to me for, in the court, like guest room. He was speaking to me for just 5 minutes.
Okay.
Then immediately he said, come. He took me. I thought, just to have something like that to his wife or somebody. When I went there, music director was sitting with the harmonium there. That is M.K. Arjunan, Arjuna master. Then I was sitting there. He gave me Srimad Thambi, he gave me the script, and he said, first he was planning to give a duet with S. Janaki, actually. But, you know, when I started, singing, he found he's eligible for a solo, something like that he felt. So immediately he said, Jollee, you will be singing a solo for Prem Nazir. At that time, singing for Prem Nazir, you can imagine.
Your first singing for Prem Nazir.
Prem Nazir. He said,
was the icon at that
icon,
time.
He said, you're singing for him. So, you sing. God bless the money. He said, then I, Jai Kan, Jai Nichavan, he gave me the concept, you know, what is the thing. He is always very bold and something like that. That feel I should bring. Then I learned. And Next day was the recording.
Okay.
Next day, Bharani studio, behind the record. I went. Then A.R. Rahman's father, Shekhar, R.K. Shekhar, he was assisting him.
Okay.
Then I learned the song. I sang. That was the first song in my life.
Okay.
From as I told you, like stage singer to film singer, they have made. That was my ambition.
So you were there for 22 long years.
Then I have afterwards, in 76, that was in 75, this first song in Malayalam. Mm. 76, I got the first Tamil song by music was, in Malayalam music was M.K. Arjunan, lyrics by Sri Kumaran Thampi.
Okay.
In Tamil, Sri Wali was the lyrics.
Okay.
Then Sri M.S. Vishwanathan was music. Vanakkathikkuriya Kadhile, that song. Malayalam was Jaikkanai Janichavan Njan, Edirkkanai Valarnavan Njan. That was my song. In Tamil it was Adiyenai Paramma Pidivadam Menamma Vanakkathikkuriya Kadhile. Vanakkathikkuriya Kadhile. That was my Tamil song. Then that was the start. Afterwards, I started singing a lot of Tamil film songs and Malayalam.
Majority, I believe you sang.
I sang Tamil. Then I started singing for all the music directors. That we say Malayalam, I sang for Salil Chaudhary and for Sham Sir,
okay.
Sham Joseph. Sir, then Dishnamurti,
okay.
Dishnamurti sir, Devarajan Master, Johnson, Devindran, A.T. Umar,
okay.
So on, like that, all the music director. So I could sing. It went on. Slowly I got into Telugu film. There also I could sing. Kannada movies I could sing.
Okay.
So these are all unexpected. See, when I get one more chance, I always think, I never knew that I can sing. But only as I told you, I always believe in prayers at that time also.
Even during those times. Though
that time also. Because after the prayer, I always
believe that you get strength from.
I get the strength. I can sing. I can do. Okay. First of all, when you go to these type of people, the main thing you have. You should have the guts to face the anything, so many. At that time, there was no track facilities. Mm-hmm. If you make mistake, that's all. Again, you have to sing. There was no track. So I should not make mistake. Pronunciation should be correct. All these things are very important. So by God's grace, I could feel that I could sing. That itself is God's grace. Because I know, at the end, even if the 12th line, if I make a mistake, again, I have to sing. Not only me, even if I sing good, with proper pronunciation and everything, if I could sing also, but if any flutist or guitarist, somebody makes a mistake also, we have to sing.
Oh, I see. So that time, the singers and everybody needed a lot of patience.
A lot of stamina, a lot of things, So it was going on like that. So, 92, up to 92, I was singing all religious songs. Hindu, Muslim.
No, 92. Up to 92, you were singing film songs as well as religious.
As a religious song. I used to sing Christian song, Hindu song, Muslim song, everything. In all languages I was singing.
For the religious album.
Any religious album.
Yeah.
I sang a lot of songs for other religious songs. But in 92, there was an incident because, I was singing a Muslim song and I was singing a Hindu devotional song. After the third one was a Christian devotional song. So when I was singing, almost all the meaning were the same. Like, you are the only God, I believe in God, you. That is the meaning in all the religious songs, You are the only one, you are the one guiding me. This is I trust in you. These are the things. The third song when I was singing, for Christian devotional song, I felt this was the song, this is the same meaning only I was singing for other religious God, So what is the sincerity behind it, I was not able to give justice to that Christian song, I was not able. Then I found, I told the producer, I said, I'm not happy, I sang. But I was not fully happy. I'll do it once again. That means that was, I want to take a decision.
Mm.
So I prayed and took a decision. Mm. This is the last. I will not sing hereafter any other religious song except Christian song.
Okay.
But still I will sing film songs.
Mm.
That was the decision 92 I took. 92.
Yeah.
During that period, you know, I started reading Bible. Mm. I was going reading Bible.
Mm.
Even though I'm born and brought up in a Catholic family, I was not reading Bible properly.
Okay.
Regularly. But I started reading Bible. Then word started speaking to me, but I was trying to avoid.
Mm.
Because the way go very go near to that, you know, I'll have to leave everything, all these things.
Mm.
During that period in church, in Madras also, there's
you're not ready to surrender, basically.
Yeah, yeah. The Madras Pentecostal Mission, there all the 14 albums I sang, I only sang.
Mm.
14 albums of their Madras Pentecostal Mission, the song, all the songs I was singing.
Mm.
So, whenever I sing that song also, word was speaking to me. But I was trying to avoid when I was singing like a song.
Hmm.
Because I don't want to go deep into that.
Okay.
But from 92 onwards, I started meditating. Then that, you know, during that 5 years time, 1997, God touched me with His powerful word, Isaiah 43:1.
Mm-hmm.
Fear not, I have redeemed you. I called you by your name and you are mine. That was the word touched my heart, changed entire my life in a different direction.
Okay.
I prayed and took a decision with my wife. I spoke to her. I feel like I don't feel like singing anymore.
Mm-hmm.
During that period, you know, 97, up to 97, I was singing for the Ilayaraja sir. Or I was singing then Johnson. My last song for Tamil was for Ilayaraja sir, I sang Oru sinna manikkuyilu sindhu padikkudali nenjukkulle nenjukkulle oru paakku vethalaya. That was the last song for Ilayaraja, that's in 96 end, December. Like that, my last song in Malayalam was for Chamayam. And that song, you know, that song was very popular. After that, you know, maybe maximum 5 months or 6 months, I fully surrendered to God, and God has given me the talent.
This was a personal decision that you
did. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
You knew that by taking this decision, you will not be able to hold that same popularity as you did.
Yeah, yeah, I know. But I was not able to sing anymore. That more stage, because the thing is, you know, I decided not to sing any other religious songs.
Mm.
In the film industry, you can't say that you don't. Whenever I go to the studio, only I, you know, I'll be able to know that the song is something. You know, that agony. And whenever I even big music directors, you know, when they call me. In one side, you know, like one side, I'm very happy that they are calling me, Raja sir are calling me, you know, like that, I'm so happy. But other side, what type of song? I'll have to say no to him, and you know, these type of agony, it was there. Mental distraction.
There was a debate in the mind.
A debate, it was going on when I'm driving the car also, and I don't know how going to be.
You were not sincere to your singing.
But then I say, God gave me a good song. But thank God, God has given a good song. But there, I know there is going to be a one point I will have to say no to all these people and then come out from the studio. And you know, as a celebrity, I was living in Chennai with all the facilities.
Mm.
Next day onwards, I can't see the income, what is going to happen.
Mm.
But I know I have to go through the wilderness.
Mm.
That is what I read in the Bible.
Yes.
Whoever achieved whatever the blessing, they will have to go through this thing. So that gave me strength.
Mm.
So one day God will be blessing you, but up to that you have to walk through.
Okay.
It may be 6 months, it may be 1 year, maybe 2 years, maybe 3 years, I don't know. It was going on.
Okay.
So I prayed, took a decision, and we were prepared, so no problem.
Okay.
So 14 months, we have gone through the wilderness, which nobody knew, except me, my wife, and God. That's all. Nobody knew. Why I didn't want others to know? The reason is, Wilderness means we cut short all the trip, unnecessary trips, expenses, going flight, you know, one of the, we started going by train and I like that, you know, and everything, we going to star hotel reduced, ordinary hotel, like that, you know, we can compromise, you know, like that, without knowing anybody. Why I took a decision like that? If I go and ask money from my parents, they will give. My brothers, they are all, you know, forget about anything, I have property in my in Kerala. If I sell also, I can. But I thought if I do now, I'll be, ridiculing God's name. Because everybody will say, they'll say, okay. Next, they'll say, decision. That's a fool, like that. I learned. I didn't do anything like that. I know we had to go through this. But 14 months we've gone through. After the 14 months, God started opening the doors like all over the world.
Amen.
All over the world, which are the countries I went as a film singer, all these stages, wherever I sang, even some places I sang, the same auditorium God called me.
Okay.
And I started singing for glory, for His glory. So God made me to this level. Now that's why I'm here. I came so many times, in Berlin.
Okay.
Then God is.
So when you took that turn, how was singing different after you became totally surrendered to Christ? And when you were singing, film songs and Christmas song earlier.
Yeah.
Now when you're totally surrendering, how was singing the experience?
I can't explain. The peace of mind, and I am at peace. And another thing is, I am doing something, when I'm singing for the film, after the song, people will clap and they come and say, you did well. Within maximum 1 hour, 2 hours, that is over. But after coming to Lord, when I was singing for the crowd, I am, Vedakinam,
Namalarile. You're throwing seeds, sowing seeds.
Sowing seeds. That feeling, I tell you, a lot of people, after so few months, they'll say, you sang, that song has touched me.
That is an investment for them, yeah.
Investment. Yeah. These type of things I never enjoyed in film industry. Previously, I still remember when we go for film song, at that time I used to pray, I used to pray, my song should be the best. See, that was the prayer. My song should be the best and I should get the maximum clap like that. That was the thing. But now it's not like that. If I am going for a concert or something like that, see, bless these people and bless the people who are coming. And not only they bless other singers, other preacher. Okay. Like that I don't want to become glory to God. God's name should be raised. And God's name should be glorified here.
Okay.
The type of feeling. So that makes me, and God has put me in the right place, and I'm so happy that I took such a decision.
Right.
And now
no
God,
regrets at all.
No regrets, and God has blessed me by all means.
Okay.
By all means, God has blessed me.
Now, having said that, what is your vision forward? Has God given you a vision in this music industry to sing with a meaning forward?
My vision is, one of the mission I had, I used to conduct a 12-hour non-stop singing program.
Mm-hmm.
Because when I was in the film world also, I've seen 24-hour singing, 12-hour singing film songs.
Mm.
Nobody has done
12 hours continuous singing?
Continuous singing.
No stopping at all?
No. All the, 6 o'clock evening we start singing.
No drinking, no eating in between?
No. Everything singing will be on the stage.
All right.
In between, choreography will be there.
Okay.
One or two. That's all. But for the songs. But that is 2001 we started. It's called MusicCare, MUSICARE.com. If you go, you can see our programs on this. MusicCare program is evening, every year, May, second Friday, evening 6 o'clock, it start to morning, next day morning 6. Full singing.
This is on the stage or on the
stage? Big stage.
And people, audience will be there?
Audience will be there. Big stage, 15,000 to 20,000 people will be there.
All right.
In all these programs,
is this conducted?
Chennai, St. George's School Ground.
Okay.
Dasiyattan, S.P. Balasubramanian, Chitra, Janaki, Vanijaram, they all attended this program. All the singers, name it, all the singers, they all came and sang. They all sang free of cost. And they sing only songs on Jesus Christ.
Amen.
They sang like that. So who are free, they come to the stage. Next year is going to be, this year is going to be May 13th, Friday evening.
2016.
Yeah. 2016. We are going to, and it's free concert. There is no ticket. Lot of people flow, like they come and go like that, you know, like the, it is a program.
Okay.
At 12 o'clock, there's a candlelight prayer, just for half an hour. That's the thing, singing. And one more thing, I used to sing in all the cities, major cities of the world and also India.
Mm.
8 years back, I started going to the villages, interior villages in North India, Orissa. I'd been to Orissa, Rajasthan, I like that, all the places. Now, this next week, February 1st, I'm going to Andhra Pradesh.
How was the experience singing in the interiors?
Oh, that is very good. Okay. That is, you know, we are going to the place where it's no road, not even the electricity. Such villages, when you go and perform, you can imagine all the entire village will come because they are first time they are seeing a sound system and guitar and all, you know, like they all come. We spend for them. We give food. And
you provide food also.
We make all the arrangements.
And so, there'll be word of God also.
Word of God, singing. And once we start singing, they all start dancing and all. You know, we also dance with them. Like mostly 2 days. You know, they make all the shamina. They do that.
Okay.
So that I'm continuing. This every year I do that. That 10 days.
That is a very it's a soul winning exercise.
Yeah, also. very good. There, you know, they really need. Because all city people, they are listening.
They're always exposed to
to a lot of programs and all. These people, no chance. So I do that.
That's wonderful. Okay.
Then I have a radio Zain, that's in Tamil. 24 hours radio, radio Zain, radio-zain.com.
Okay, you run that.
That is
internet media.
Internet radio. Radio. Mm. That is songs, jokes, then. Medical tips and cookery, everything is there.
It's for
children.
It's purely internet-related.
Internet-related. Okay. That we are doing. And we have a recording studio called Rohit Recordings.
Okay.
There I produce Tamil, Telugu, Malayalam, Hindi, all the albums. And now I'm going like all these interior area to sing. There I want to spend our own money.
Any particular experience you want to narrate to singing in these interior places?
When you go to such places, you know, see, I've never seen, I've seen, you know, like some ladies, you know, they when you look at it, it will be like a snake, they dance and all, you're like, maybe evil spirit, you know,
evil
something
spirit.
Like that.
Okay.
I never seen before that, you know, once we go to this Oriya area,
okay.
I've seen like they do, like scrawling in the
when you're singing
I'm sure it's not because of my singing or style or it's not that but I'm sure some because
the
word of power
the
power of God, you know, powerful word when it reaches that place become, you know.
Having said that, you know, there is would you like to tell the audience how there is something called cult music also. There's something called cult music. So, not every music is spiritual. Not every music is creating a well-being. You know, there are some music that is being used for healing also, where the words embedded for well-being. But at the same time, music can be used for negative aspects. Or that's what I understand.
Yeah.
So, would you like to say something to the audience about the cult music?
Cult music, you know, I should say in music. You take anything, there's a good side and bad side.
Okay.
You take internet, there's a good side and bad side.
Yes.
Like fashion, good side and bad side, you know, like everything. Like that music also, I've got. Even film music, there's a good film and also a very bad film.
Mm.
So, if I could, God has given the wisdom to take, select
power,
which you say, the discerning power, that's all. When this cult music, sometimes, you know, children will be more attracted. Why should I? I tell you one thing. At that age, you know, when you go to another country, first the people will learn. All the children also learn the vulgar words. Am I correct?
Yeah,
am I correct?
True.
It's very easily get into that. Then only afterwards only we go to the language side, you know.
Okay.
When I went to Chennai also first time, I learned first to nasty firing words and all sorts of things.
Okay.
Like that. So the cult music has got that attraction.
Mm.
So it has got 60 words or other. Avoid that, listening that, then automatically there's a temptation for the, you know, going into that. So better to, you always go to listen the good music. Music has got, you know, that power to, you know,
transform.
That is definitely there.
Yeah, music has got the power to transform. That's, if the music has the power, got the power to transform. You know,
you become,
there is a saying that you are what you worship.
Yeah, yeah.
You become what you worship.
Yeah, yeah.
And that is the case, you know, being a Christian singer who worships, sings the spiritual songs, do you think as yourself, as anybody else who would sing spiritual songs, would they be like the object of worship?
No, what I mean is worship, what I felt, you know, in the real worship means in Psalms 144:9 says that I sing a new song to you, O God, with a harp as an instrument of ten strings.
Mm.
If 10 strings, I have gone through, I went to the internet, I tried.
Mm.
Harpily, not 10 strings, harpily more than that.
Yeah.
In Malayalam, it is Veena, Tamil Veena, Tambura. In all these things, there's nowhere 10 strings is there.
Okay.
But 10 strings means, what I feel, symbolically they said, that harp is our body.
Mm-hmm.
That means two hands, legs, then two eyes, ears, heart, tongue, you know, mouth, tongue. These 10 things, work, point out, you know, like, you know, concentrate in a worship, then only it becomes a complete worship.
Okay.
Am I correct? When we are singing, you know, like our eye attraction goes to something, then it becomes, there's a blockage there. Exactly like that, ears,
yes.
You know.
Okay,
so there is something like that. So when we do such worship, we are bringing an atmosphere that we are bringing the crowd or bringing the people and bringing ourselves also nearing to the God.
Okay.
We will
that is
become
an experience by yourself.
Yeah. So we are bringing we are preparing by worship, we are preparing the people very near to the God, you know, like.
Yeah.
And then at that time it will be easier for them, even if somebody giving a message, or it will be easier to, you know,
yes.
to get into their heart.
So my question was that too, when we worship like that, you know, is it possible that we could get the character of the God that we worship?
Yeah, some part. It's not exactly like that,
yeah,
but
more
still,
more.
Yeah, it is there. Yeah,
yeah. It is there.
So we forget about our worries and everything. So we are nearing to the God. We are near to the God at that time. If you read Bible also. It will reach immediately, the word will, you know, reach our thing.
This worship aspect is something where people do not really understand. There are a lot of people who say, listen, and I read the word of God. I worship, I like the songs, but songs are sung by people. I don't sing, and I am not good at singing. So I don't believe in the worship, really lifting my hands, clapping hands and singing loud or so. But I just want to be in the church, listen to the music and go back home. You know, and we don't understand the worship. Worship aspect becomes just a initial thing before the speech. You know, so they treat this as just the first initial part of the worship or the church worship.
Yes.
Now, how would you like to tell the audience what is the importance of worship as such?
That's what I'm saying. You know, like you are bringing the atmosphere, and
all,
we are bringing
all the 10 strings.
Ten strings should work. Yeah. According to me, that they can clap, they can begin. Bible also it says Psalms. You know, we have to clap and with you know. Oh, say you like a sound.
Worship and spirit.
Spirit. And
now, that is where many of them ask this question. Is it necessary that, does God need my worship? I mean, there are other people, there are angels worshipping. Why would I need to worship? Because I'm not a big singer. There could be others worshipping.
It's not necessary that you have to be a singer. Yeah? He can just join with them and then be a part of it. That's all. It's not necessary. But he can see when you do the worship, it's not there. People are not going to say you are singing with the Shruti or the, if you are in front of the mic, you may have to keep. Be careful, because you should not spoil other things. But if you are not in front of the mic or something, you can loudly sing. What is nothing
that's
wrong?
It, because worship is an experience.
Experience. Right? When you do the experience,
it is not just to please God. It is actually for us to experience the
experience the presence of God, and then you clap and enjoy. Like that. I always tell them, you clap. What is that is what said in the Bible.
Okay.
If you believe in Bible, you have to. Obey the Bible also, correct?
Right, right.
If you believe, or else you should not say, I don't believe this, I don't believe this. Once we believing it, you do that. Clap, enjoy.
Yeah.
And
that's what the Bible says.
That's what Bible says. Enjoy you do worship. That. Do that.
Is there any particular song that is so close to your heart that you would like to sing to the audience? A few lines. Or?
Yeah. In which language?
Any of the languages. I think Tamil is more close.
Tamil.
To you.
Being a Malayali, I sing a lot of Malayalam also.
Yeah.
You want me to sing?
Okay.
I'll sing a Tamil song. Okay. எந்தன் ஜபவேளை உமை தேடி வந்தேன் தேவா பதில் தாருமே எந்தன் கோட்டை எந்தன் தஞ்சம் நீரே உமை நான் நாடி வந்தேன் எந்தன் ஜபவேளை உமை தேடி வந்தேன் தேவா பதில் தாருமே எந்தன் கோட்டை எந்தன் தஞ்சம் நீரே உம்மை நான் நாடி வந்தே.
What does the song mean?
It is I'm praying to you, oh God, Deva, you give answer to my prayers.
Okay. All right. Wonderful.
I'm distressed. Yeah, yeah, that's the thing.
What do you like to, being a veteran singer in the spiritual arena, what would you like to, what kind of advice would you like to give to the youngsters around?
I want to say only one thing. When you sing for the Lord, first of all, that song should minister to you. Then only it will minister to others. That's all. Very simple. So you have to go the meaning, you have to look into the meaning. Why? If you have got any doubt, ask the lyric writer or whoever it may be, ask them what it means, what is the thing. Then you get more involvement, which I was doing at that time. Now, at least a little bit, if I got any doubt, I'll refer the Bible. I always carry a Bible before the, always carry. So I read the thing, I got any doubt. Also, I used to discuss with the lyric writer, producer, this is what is the meaning of this, tell me. Then they
the song should minister to you before you really
that's
sing it across.
That is always, not only, it's not like other songs, when you sing and finish off, that's all. This is, as I said, it's not one day matter. This is for,
forever.
Forever.
It's a singing and praising is forever. Eternal life, that's what we're going to do. Amen. Brother Jollee, thanks for joining us today.
Thank you so much.
As I hope you're all blessed by Brother Jollee joining us here and the wonderful testimonies that we heard, the wonderful experience that he had, and how God is still using him these days. And as you know, we never end any of the eye to eye sessions without the man of God praying for you. I would now request Brother Jollee Abraham to say a word of prayer for the audience.
Heavenly Father, we come to your wonderful presence, Lord. Bless all these viewers who are listening to this RBN interview. Make this interview as an instrument for people to come to you, O Lord. Thank you for listening our prayers and answering our prayers. Thank you, Lord. We ask this in the precious name of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.